What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Modded Ark series. So we're upstairs. Of course, it's almost nighttime. I had tamed another Pteranodon. I have no idea where the other one went at all. He just was over there. The Anunnaki mod actually uninstalled and came back, so I did a wild dino wipe again, and I don't see any dinosaurs in the area. I probably have to fly away to find dinosaur spawns. I'm not completely sure. And I've been working, and I installed a new mod called the Kibble Vending Machine mod. It was recommended in the comment section. Somebody saying, Kibble's just kind of annoying to get. Just get the Kibble Vending Machine, and it makes everything easier. So we have all these Kibbles available to us, and all it takes is like 30 metal. I put a stack of metal in here, and we're able to do all this different Kibble to tame stuff so much quicker. We also got the Anunnaki smithy, which has all these goodies things, these matrix primidoruses and crazy stuff like this. And we have the metal storage vault that's like smaller than a normal storage vault. And then we have this Anunnaki forge, and we have the smithy that we just placed down. And we're actually in the process of working out how to make these special darts, I believe. Are they in here? Yeah. So these poison darts. It's just a pretty much a better version of the poison arrow. And we needed sedatives, cementing paste, and trank darts. And I think I have enough stuff for trank darts in here. I need to grab the narcotics out of here. We also needed a ton of rare mushrooms, so I headed over to the swamp nearby and got plenty of rare mushrooms. And now I'm in the process of creating these trank darts. We'll make 66 of them. And metal's just been pretty much easy ever since that hill up there, and making everything so much easier, dropping it down, getting everything done. I want to try to tame something really cool today. I'll probably knock it out and then figure out what I want to do with it. I just don't know if I'm going to be able to take hits now that I'm wearing flak armor. I don't know how strong these higher level dinos actually are. I also leveled myself up fully to 100. That way I'd be able to unlock everything, like these matrix and whatever the matrix is that are going to allow me to do these special things. But we need essences of like these different types of something that I've never figured out. So we'll find out this stuff as we go. Here's some trank darts. Throw the trank darts. I don't even think we need them in here, do we? Yeah, I think we do. Weapons, ammo. We need sedatives, which is the rare mushrooms and narcotics. That's why I have these here. Sedatives right here. And then we need a little bit of hide, which I think I have in here. And then we need a bit of crystal, which we have downstairs. It took me a while to find our base again. I had to just run around for a while. I put down a bed now. That's the first time I died, and I just didn't think of even putting down a bed. Where's our crystal? Over here. There it is. I haven't even thought of, like, putting down a bed, and I just thought of putting one down, like, as soon as I got back. I think we're going to need... What are we going to need more of? Cementing paste. We have plenty of cementing paste because of the beaver dam right out front of my house. Makes everything a lot easier. I think we just need more cementing paste again. There's just a lot of cementing paste. Good thing there's a beaver dam right outside. And then once the cementing paste runs out, we're going to need a bit of hide, so we're going to have to kill something. I don't have any regular metal arrows. I don't even think I have a researched metal arrow. Yeah, I do have it researched. We should probably craft some, and then we can kill, like, smaller dinosaurs. I could just use my Pteranodon. He's pretty strong. Everything said and done, so... But we have 8 sedative narcotics. Significantly increases your health, but puts you into a deep sedative state. We're going to pop out front. I think we have... Yeah, we only have 1 hide left. So we're going to have to hop on our Pteranodon and kill something for some hide. But this kibble machine is going to be pretty awesome. I'm looking forward to using it. I always hated the process of kibble. And that's what the whole modded series is for. Pretty much just to make everything a little bit easier. By changing stuff and adding mods that make things easier. I would never add anything like that to the multiplayer server at all, because it's just a little too unbalanced and too easy to do. So then we throw some sedative narcotics in here, and then some cementing paste, and we have 8 of them. And these load into the long neck that we just created. And we should be able to knock out pretty much everything and anything now. So here we go. Let's load this up. I wish there was a mod where I could do multiple attachments on the long neck. There's got to be an attachments mod. I'm still looking into mods and stuff. Every time I think of something, I look it up and see if I can find one that works. Like this vending machine mod, it was literally just like, stacks with everything, works with everything, it's awesome. And I'm just like, okay, sounds like a plan, I'll do it. Might as well. Assuming that we can actually tame everything with kibble, like the badass dinosaurs and the alphas. So I want to tame like a really strong flying mount today, I feel like. Just a really, really strong one. That way we can take out some bigger stuff with just a really strong, like, Argentavis or something. But we're going to need more hide to make more sedatives, and I'm going to need to make some metal arrows. I think, do we use the fabricator for metal arrows? Yeah, we do. Always get confused of what the fabricator and, like, which one the smithy is. Well, not which one they are, but which one you use to craft stuff. Especially popping in and out of, popping in and out of, what's it called? Survival of the fittest always confuses me a ton as well. So we need cementing paste. Cementing paste, which we have on us. Just gonna throw metal in there as well, because I know we're gonna need metal. We have metal upstairs. So I added this little ramp in the back, obviously, to get up to this floor. This is gonna be like the modded floor, is technically what I'm gonna call it. I need to make a better way of getting up here. This is also the Royal Engineers. It's literally called the Royal Engineers Workstation. I didn't rename it or anything. And this is where we build all those special wall things and stuff, which we'll get into. We'll definitely build like a really cool castle eventually. But right now I really am interested in this Anunnaki mod, and I want to get more stuff going with this. We have metal in here, I believe. I am encumbered. What else is new? What else is new, game? We have 100 metal. I'm almost about to just break a wall back here, just to have a door back here to make everything a little bit easier. So I'm going to return a little bit once I have some metal arrows, and we're ready to go. Just so you guys don't have to watch me, like, scour around and try to craft this stuff. So, we have obsidian and everything. It shouldn't be too hard. Alright, metal arrows are all crafted up. The fabricator is turned off. That way I don't waste my gasoline. And now we're going to roll out and kind of look around for some stuff. And maybe be able to find some of those higher tier things to kill. I do need some hide just so we can make a few more of those new, like, different type of darts, the Anunnaki darts. Not sure what I'm going to kill, though. Need some kind of easy that's going to give me a whole bunch. Look at this trike down here. There's two of them, though. I don't really want to deal with two of them. Oh, my. There's so many pteranodons down here, man. If we needed a pteranodon army, I could get it no problem. Ooh, what is that? Okay, so there's a... I think that's a fire... badass trike, and I think they're hostile towards everything. I really should get a spyglass. That's gonna help me a ton. Let's get a spyglass going for sure, because the spyglass is gonna help me, like, look at stuff from afar. Spyglass. How does one craft a spyglass? We need a bit of crystal and hide and wood, but we need to get hide anyway. That's like a special kind of raptor as well. Holy crap, that raptor's fast. Those are the kind of ones that I want to take out and tame so I can have those crazy things. And I don't think they use regular, I think there is, like, actual, like, alpha saddles. Yeah, so see all these different alpha saddles and stuff. There's different types of saddles, and they're harder to craft because they're stronger dinosaurs that you can get. So let's kill something. We can kill one of these beavers. These beaver dams are also giving me rare mushrooms as well, I found out. And that definitely helps. Oh, what kind of beaver is that? This is where I need a spyglass. I don't want to... Okay, give me a second. That's like a blue sparkly beaver. That's cool as hell. And then there's another one of these. I think that was a special Dimorphodon, and there's a special raptor. Holy crap, those things are big and fast, huh? I think we're going to need a Quetzal. That's what I feel like. We might need a Quetzal just so we can stay in midair to tame these things. There's no way we're taming them on the ground. Whoa, that's like an alpha spino, I think. So there's a lot of stuff everywhere. This is pretty cool. But I need a spyglass, and I need something to kill that's nice and easy. I don't want to kill a turtle, because they're not going to give me much hide. They're going to give me more keratin than anything. Just need to kill something easy. A dodo. What did I just fly over? Was that a dodo? It wasn't a dodo, it was one of these doggies. I'm sorry, doggy, but I'm going to need your hide, buddy. 84, that's not quite enough, but there is a trike right here. And trike plus compound bow, very easy kill. Give me some of my metal arrows back. One thing I don't like about 10 times is just the amount of prime meat that I can easily get off of anything. And it just gives me so much, and it's so hard to drop because it doesn't stack up. So I kind of have to drop it very often. That's kind of what happens in 10 times. There we go. And now we can probably fly back. I think we have just enough hide to be able to do some stuff. Be able to get some more darts going and then be able to take down something a little bit more vicious, a little bit more stronger. Get a spyglass that we can see what's going on, like that special stego right there. I'll start learning like the actual proper terms of each like individual type of special dinosaur just by like their color and stuff, but it's going to take me a bit of time. So I'm going to fly back. I'm going to craft up a few more of those darts. I'll see you guys in a second. All right, I'm crafting 6 more. I deleted this corner in order to get up quicker to jump on that bin, jump on that bin. I can't do that, but now I can just go down and I can access any of these 3 bins, no problem, and then just jump back up. It's probably just an easy way. But in the process, I forgot that this thing was in the corner and I broke it. But the okay thing about that is it's really easy to craft. I think it was like 30 crystal and something else, or it's 30 metal, 2 crystal, so not the hardest thing ever to craft. But we're going to need it if we knock something out. I just don't know what we're going to knock out yet. I kind of want to knock out a Quetzal because I feel like we're going to need to platform saddle in order to even tame any of these larger special dinosaurs. And then we also got this bad boy to see what level things are so we can kind of learn names and figure stuff out. Also, stupid Utahraptor came up and tried messing with us. I'm curious as to what that beaver is. Like, what is it? Okay, so that's a badass beaver. So I don't really want to tame that, but it does sound cool. I need to not hop on my Pteranodon with that thing on because it always bugs out. Oh, I'm overweight. I probably have a bunch of shit on me. Yep, a bunch of shit on me from crafting. Also tried to break some back walls, and then I realized the fabricator in the smithy was actually keeping me from even going in there anyway. And also, I've stopped caring about organizing my inventory. I got too lazy and just started throwing things into bins, so it sucks, but I'll figure it out later. So let's fly off. Let's go investigate around a little bit. I think I want to tame a Quetzal, which is, I believe, Pteranodon kibble, which is going to be really easy for us to get. Again, that way we have that metal converts to kibble kind of thing. I'm just curious as to how many of these darts it's going to take out a Quetzal. Here's one here, actually, that I found earlier. I'm going to try to shoot it from, like, the cliffside. There was a poison T-Rex somewhere over here, and it's pretty scary to see one of those bad boys, so we need to be a little careful. I'm just going to see. Yeah, there he is. There's the poison T-Rex that I was talking about. I believe it's called the poison T-Rex. If we go up on this side and spyglass it real quick, I'll let you know exactly what it's called. But it is pretty freaking cool looking. So that's a badass T-Rex, and I heard that scorpion coming out of nowhere. And, of course, we get a little bit of map lag there. Level 133 Scorpion. Badass Ankylosaurus has been defeated. I didn't defeat that. Oh, we got a Javelin. Hell yeah. So this is a melee weapon type of poison to knock out smaller enemies. Good thing, good thing. Okay, and that was what? A badass? I believe it was a badass Tyrannosaurus Rex Wild. Can we knock this out with 14 darts? Just out of full curiosity. I just don't know, because if we can knock this out and tame it, I'm down. I just potato aimed that so hard. This is like this is the best angle that I'm probably ever going to get on one of these things, so. Where is it running? I'm definitely hitting it. I just don't know how much topor these things have. You'd imagine putting the metal Rex armor on one of these things? Can we even tame badasses, or do we only kill badasses? I remember somebody telling me if I can tame alphas, but I think badasses can't be tamed. I think they're killed as bosses. So now that I think of it, we're going to have to kill this, but I don't have enough arrows for that. Badasses can't be tamed, alphas can, because there's no badass saddles from what I've seen. What level T-Rex is that? 106. Jesus, okay. I got, like, the lowest level Pteranodon ever then, huh? I think I tamed it at, like, 40? A little under 40? It's leveled up a few times. I'm killing some Utahraptors and stuff in the area. So that's crazy. I need to find... I think I'm just going to go for the Quetzal honestly. What is that? Is that a giant purple monkey? Holy shit, that thing was fast. Okay. I need to remember to stop getting on with that thing. Alright, where'd the Quetz run off to? Even if I knocked out the Quetz there, I feel like we would have had issues. There's like a red scorpion over there or something. That's like making everything a little angry. Is that thing really attacking me? What did I do? I didn't do anything. Yeah, it was angry at me for some reason. I'm not sure why. Yeah, it's like a red scorpion of some sort. Not really sure. I didn't really accomplish anything this episode, and I want to accomplish something, but I'm just, like, so amazed by just looking at everything. I want to get, like, maybe, like, an alpha Pteranodon, if that's a thing somewhere. I just think I need a Quetzal, and the only way I can really get a Quetzal is if I get a Argentavis, and then pick up a scorpion that I have tamed, set on aggressive, and poke him. Unless we can get lucky and, like, land on a cliffside where it is. But I'm not really seeing where the Quetzal flew off to. I really want to get that kibble machine to use, and it would be crazy easy to tame on a 5x tame with a kibble machine. That should be so simple. Oh, there he is. Okay. How can we possibly hit this guy? I'm trying to think. I mean, I'm thinking one of these darts is probably equal to maybe like 10 to 15 tranquilizer darts in general, because they do take like a lot to craft. I'm just not sure of their actual like topor that they deal, and they're so hard to craft, and I just use so many of them on that badass T-Rex, remembering that somebody told me that you can't tame them that way. I hit it with it. Now let's just follow it. And maybe, just maybe, that's enough to pass one out. Unless it's a crazy high level one. Okay, we hit it. Let's get up to, like, this next one, maybe. Right here, maybe. And see if we can knock it out again. Or hit it again. There we go. I did hit it again. Now let's follow it. And then I think this cliffside might be good for another hit. If it stops flying so fast. This will be perfect for a headshot, actually. We've hit it 3 times. I haven't looked at its level yet. Okay, it's going to fly right over here to this cliff one. We should be able to hit it from here as well. There we go, hit it again. I want to look at its level, but I don't want to lose track of it. So he should be flying just over to this cliffside now. And I should be able to hit him from here. I should probably spyglass him real quick just to see his level. He's probably a crazy high level if he just took that many of those types of darts. What have I hit him with, like 4 so far? Level 40, not terribly high. One of the lower things that you could actually probably get on the server. Alright, that one's down. Don't land in the water. Perfect. Okay, we got the Quetzal down. Now it's just a matter of time of getting that kibble machine all set up. I think that's a badass bear across the water, or an alpha bear. I think it might be an alpha bear. Okay, so we're gonna have to fly home. Ooh, I don't have any of their narcotics on me. Okay, we gotta fly home quickly. We need to craft one of the kibble machines and get Pteranodon kibble very quickly, and we need to get this thing back. So I'll return in just a second when I have everything that's required of me. Alright, I am back, and I brain farted a little bit, and as I made the 10 Pteranodon kibble, I was like, no, it's not Pteranodon, it's Rex. What am I, stupid? And I made Rex kibble as well. We had plenty of raw metal to go around, so it's all good. He's got 100 narcotics in him, just under 100, because I've been using a few of them. And we have the 10 Rex egg kibble. I'm just going to take out the Pteranodon kibble. I'm just going to put it in my Pteranodon. He's just going to eat it for normal food. Since it's just metal to get it, it's not really that hard to get. We're going to be naming this bad boy Joker. As you could tell by his color scheme, he is green and purple. So that's going to be awesome. So that is a Alpha Dire Bear. Level 106 Alpha Dire Bear. Dire Bear. Alpha Dire Bear. He's actually going down very fast in food. It's actually taking quite quickly, so he's not going to take that long to tame. He did eat one of the Pteranodon kibble because I put in the wrong one in the beginning. You see that little sliver? And I was like, damn it, I just wasted a whole bunch of time because he could have already eaten Rek'Sai kibble. I'm not sure how long this is going to take. I don't have a Quetzal saddle, but we'll probably just make a platform one either in the next episode or in between the next two episodes and see just kind of like this is probably what's required of us, to be honest. I guarantee this is pretty much going to be required to tame anything of like a dire stature. So this guy's going to be taking quite a while to tame. He's down and out. I'm going to return when he's finished, I guess. That's all we really can do. I don't want to just sit here and wait. And I'll see you guys in a little bit. All right, so this bad boy's tamed. We're going to fly home. I'm going to craft up a platform saddle. It's probably going to take me a little bit, and we'll have it for the next episode. But hopefully you enjoyed. Joker is ready to join the family, and then hopefully we'll be able to tame some of these alpha dinosaurs. I want to try to maybe get one of each alpha dinosaur. I feel like that'd be really cool. Also, pretty soon, I think later this week, you guys are probably going to see a little bit of castle building, because I do want to start using that cool architecture mod. I think we need to fly a little bit more to the left. I really want to show you guys that cool elk architecture mod. I think this was a pretty cool tame, all things considered. The fact that we tamed him without, like, any other flying dinosaurs. Well, I guess we have the Pteranodon, but you know what I mean. Jumping in between the pillars and shooting it and having it pass out in the right location and making sure it didn't fall in the water was pretty cool. So leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in another Modern Ark episode later. I'm not really sure. Maybe I'll start posting these daily. You guys really do seem to like them. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Adios.